we turn to John McAfee, pioneer in the cybersecurity industry, CEO of MGT Capital Investments, political activist. He sought the Libertarian Party's presidential nomination in 2016. He joins me from Oakland. Heard all the headlines about hacks, the Democratic National Committee being hacked, John Podesta being hacked, Russia's alleged efforts to influence the election. What's your take on all of this?
Well, there's so much information out there, Larry, that I think to start with, we need to define what cybersecurity is. I mean, there's the protection of our privacy, which we have none, by the way. There's the protection of our data, our critical data. We have none of that. There's the protection against cyber attacks, like denial of service attacks against internet organizations where we can no longer get access to the internet or a company's computer goes down. And then far more importantly, we have cyber warfare. The only front that we are, America has any capability in is in cyber warfare. That began back in 2011 with Stuxnet, a virus written jointly by the U.S. and Israel that destroyed half of Iran's centrifuges to create purified uranium. So the thing that distresses me more than anything else is that our government defines cybersecurity, by and large, especially the FBI, the Department of Justice, as using cyber technology to make sure that American citizens toe the line, that there are no terrorist activities, and that we are all monitored and controlled. And this is what scares me, because that really is not cybersecurity. The thing about Donald Trump's cybersecurity platform is that he wants the Department of Justice. The agency that's going to head that up, we know, is going to be the FBI. They are the lead technologists within the Department of Justice. And look at what happened to the FBI. In 2013, they were shut down by Anonymous. In 2015, the Chinese stole every record that the FBI had. And in February of this year, a 15-year-old boy hacked the FBI and published 30,000 records, including undercover agents of every agent within the FBI organization, almost 80% of their employees. And is this the agency that you want running America's cybersecurity? Well, there must be another. I'm sorry, sir. Go ahead.
And what is John McAfee's idea?
Well, my idea is let's address the real cybersecurity problem. For example, what the FBI has, what the NSA has, what every covert agency within the U.S. government has is software and hardware capable of listening in on every conversation between every American citizen, reading every text message, reading every email, knowing who our contacts are, knowing everything about us. And these are being used against us now. Why don't we take all of that effort and realize that the American government itself has no security? The Chinese walked off with 23 million records from the Office of Personnel Management last year, as easy as could be. And yet that office was protected by the state-of-the-art cyber protection technology. We don't have any.
You think Russia attacked Russia attacked the Democratic Party? Do you think the DNC and Podesta, they were Julian Assange had anything to do with this? What's your view of that?
Okay, well, here's the truth is, Larry, when the FBI or when any other agency says the Russians did it or the Chinese did something or the Iranians did something, that's a fallacy. Any hacker capable of breaking into something is extraordinarily capable of hiding their tracks. If I was the Chinese and I wanted to make it look like the Russians did it, I would use Russian language within the code. I would use Russian techniques of breaking into organizations. So there simply is no way to assign a source for any attack. This is a fallacy. This is what the FBI and other agencies want us to believe so that they can manipulate our opinions. But I can promise you, if it looks like the Russians did it, then I can guarantee you it was not the Russians.
What do you think of WikiLeaks?
You know, I believe that we should know, as American citizens, the truth of what is happening within our government, Larry. You know, our government wants to say, well, we have secrets that we must protect. There are no secrets anymore. If the U.S. government believes that the Russians, the Chinese, the Iranians do not already have all of our secrets because of their hacking technologies, then our government is deluding itself. So WikiLeaks, you know, it's a tricky question. But I would rather know. I would rather know that my government is doing something illegal, like having the NSA spy on me and you and others, than not to know. Surely this is the only sane way to look at this.
What's the purpose? The old comic strip Pogo used to say, we have found the enemy and it is us. Why would the government want to hack John McAfee's computer? Why? What possible
reason?
Why?
Well, if it's me, then it's for any number of reasons. I'm the most outspoken critic of the FBI.
So what?
Of the NSA.
Is it America? You can criticize them. They hack you to find out what?
To find out who I'm talking to, who my friends are. Am I involved in some subversive organization? Am I doing something anti-American or undemocratic? Am I doing something that might in some way harm the administration? Or divulge a secret which I may possess. But I have the right to privacy. It's in the Constitution. And yet I have no privacy, and neither do you, Larry. If you think that just because you are not of a political activist or you're not speaking out against a government agency, that they may not be looking into your life, I know that they are. Why? You are an important person. You influence millions of Americans. So of course they want to know what you're thinking, what you're doing, who your friends are, and what you're saying. And I'm not being paranoid. This is just the facts of life as they exist today, Larry.
We'll be right back with more politicking.